Today we're going to be talking about master follower configurations and how KEB enables synchronous motion profiles with encoder-based operation. VFDs or drives are used in a variety of industrial applications. These applications can often be broken down into single-axis applications and multi-axis applications. Obviously, in a single-axis application, a single drive is run independently of other drives. In a multi-axis application, the drives work together. This can be as simple as discrete I/O being transferred between the drives, or in the most advanced applications, a master follower configuration. Master follower applications are when one or more follower drives are synchronized to a master drive. The master drive provides a position or speed reference that's transmitted to the follower drives, where the follower drives synchronize to that motion profile. The follower drives have a lot of flexibility also. They're electronically geared to the master shaft, and in this way, the gear ratio can also be altered. So for example, the follower drive can be ran in a 2-to-1 ratio, or a 1-to-2 ratio, or even reversed entirely. One of the primary challenges of master follower applications is ensuring the fast cycle times that are required to synchronize the drives. For example, if the cycle time is too slow, if one drive is running very fast, the follower drive isn't synchronizing to that profile fast enough. So the follower drive will fall behind, and if these shafts are coupled rigidly together, even a few degrees of error is enough to have catastrophic results. KEB provides master follower solutions in a variety of ways. One of these ways is over encoder signals. Encoder signals already provide cycle times on the order of microseconds, so this is more than enough to get the follower drive to synchronize in the master drive. It's also simple on a hardware side because all you need is an encoder cable to synchronize the drives together. To demonstrate master follower configuration, we have two S6s set up as a demo. KEB's most recent firmware, coupled with our A control card and P control card, enable master follower over an encoder cable. We have this as the master drive, and this drive is sending an incremental encoder signal over the encoder cable, and the follower drive receives that signal as a command point. Even without a PLC, we can run this drive in the forward direction, and the follower drive will then reference that set point and follow it. Once we have the hardware set up, we can go into KEB's drive programming software, COMBIVIS 6, to show you how we would set this up. So we'll be starting from both drives being set up with their corresponding motors. After the motor learn, each drive will be set up in velocity mode, so that'll be the starting point. The first thing we need to do is establish the encoder connection between the drives. So both drives are connected with an incremental encoder cable on both sides of the drive. So the first thing we need to do is go into the master drive here, and then go under wizards, and then we would go under feedback mode, and then you'll see there's encoder A and then encoder B. Encoder B, we're going to set to TTL output. This means that the master drive will be sending out a virtual encoder signal. So we'll confirm this. And now the master drive is sending out a virtual incremental encoder signal. So now that that's done, we'll go under the follower drive tab. Here we go. We would go under wizards again, and then go under feedback mode. Here again, we have encoder A and encoder B, and we want to set up encoder B to read those incremental encoder signals. So we would go here and select TTL/HTL with zero signal. And from there, we'll hit confirm. And now this drive is going to go into an encoder identification. It'll stay in this state until the master drive then rotates its shaft, which we'll do now. And now it's detected the TTL encoder. So this verifies that everything is working correctly. And now we want to actually go into the follower drive and then set up the profile position. So a master follower is done in the profile position mode. So we go under CO parameters and go under CO01, modes of operation. By default, it's in velocity mode, and we want to set this to profile position mode. We'll hit OK here. And then the big thing we have to do is set this CO04 and set the master channel to channel B. This is that encoder link, so now the follower drive will reference that encoder channel when it goes to run. There's still a couple settings we have to adjust. We're going to go under the position control parameters, the PS parameters, and we'll scroll down to PS48. And this is the acceleration for the position profile. By default, it's a pretty small value, so we're actually going to go to the upper limit here, copy this value, and paste it here. And we also want to go to PS60 and set this to a value of 75. Now, what we just did there is the process of getting the follower drive to follow as closely as possible to the master signal. We've set our acceleration to the max, and we've also set a linear position profile. So it's going to follow as closely as it can to the master signal. And from there, the final thing to do is to go to PS33. Right now, we're not in master follower mode just yet. The thing we have to do to actually enter master follower mode is select either speed synchronous or angular synchronous. These are two versions of master follower, and speed synchronous means that the follower drive will reference the master drive's speed. The thing here is it then won't correct for accumulated position errors over time. If you select angular synchronous, which we're going to do here, the drive will reference the master position and drive to that. And it'll also correct for accumulated position errors over time. So we'll hit OK. And you can also set velocity limits. You can set things like virtual gear ratios, but we're not going to do that here. And the next thing now is we can actually enable this drive. Everything is set up now for master follower mode. So we're going to set our control word to enable. So now the drive is running. And if I rotate the shaft, it actually won't follow the drive just yet. There's still one more bit we have to set. It's this bit 16, operating mode specific for. So if I was a PLC, I would pulse this. Here I'm just going to turn it on and off again. And now the follower shaft is following the master shaft. You can see, for example, in the scope, if I turn the shaft manually, this red line is the master shaft, and this blue line is the follower shaft. And you can see these will follow closely when the master shaft is rotated. Now that we have master follower working, let's explain some of the benefits of this solution. Without master follower, one of the primary ways to get two shafts to synchronize together is with mechanical coupling. This could be gears or belts. One thing these have in common is they're very rigid and not very flexible. With master follower, it doesn't matter where you place the drives, the software is easily changed. We can virtually adjust the gear ratios and the direction of the movement. Another benefit is scalability. As opposed to mechanical solutions like belts and gears, it's very easy to add more motor shafts to the solution. Another benefit is load distribution. For example, when you have multiple motors in the system, each of these motors is contributing torque to the system. This allows you to have multiple smaller motors as opposed to one large motor that has to generate all the torque that the system needs. And finally, master follower reduces the load on the PLC. When we're not using a PLC because the encoder cable is taking over the synchronization, this allows us to either eliminate the PLC or reduce the size. This means less programming and also reduced costs. Master Follower leverages the fast cycle times of encoder-based operation to implement real-time reliability and scalability. If you have any other questions, feel free to reach out to us at KEB America.